Thank you, Madam Moderator. Let's go in prayer to our Creator. Most High Father, Lord of all, you care for your children, big and small. And even when we're all doubting Thomas's, you are faithful to all of your promises. So help us, please, think beyond when we leave and consider how to pass down what we believe. And when our time here on earth is done, you're faithful still to the next generation. So let our work be worthy of your enduring word as we pray all of this in the name of our Lord. Our Lord who has come and will come again, to whom be the glory forever. Amen. Today I represent the Next Gen Committee. And to give you a report, I wrote this little ditty. To have a little fun with this short time, to inspire and enjoy, I wrote it in rhyme. So you heard Dr. Stetzer speak of the import of the Next Gen, so I lifted this report to the language of poetry to this high court, so that can urge us on, but I'll keep it short. You can read our written report on your own. The details are there. I won't make you groan. See, as we heard, the moment we're in doesn't pause, doesn't stop the mission that's been driving us forward since GA1 to pursue our Lord and seek the kingdom. So it's time to think hard about the future of this body. 42 years going strong, we've moved on from the lobby. But to make sure we're not heading for the graveyard, the Next Gen Committee's been working real hard. Listen, the truth of the matter, after all this content, of all American Christians, 94% were under 18 when they prayed to God to repent. If that was you, don't be shy, represent. See, at the crux, at the forefront of all our ambitions, whether it's evangelism here or our global missions, from crafting and filling our leadership pipeline to making our church more like Rev 7-9, your Next Gen is already there. So welcome and listen, don't be scared. My safe bet is that your children and youth are more diverse and more willing to share truth. So we must think, starting now, let's begin, about these comfortable seats you're sitting in. Who's sitting there and there and there at GA 52? Who's coming next? Who's following you? Are these seats too comfy for our backsides? Or can we rest on God's faithfulness applied? Who's sitting there in 10 years? You decide. From Gray to Dean and Stetzer to McKee, we've heard the plea, we've got to reach Gen Z. And the good news is this, there's people among us who probably aren't sitting here among us. They're working with kids, playing among us, ministering in ways good and humongous. They're the Next Gen workers, paid or volunteer, working with children, youth, and college each year. And just like us, they need one another. They need the encouragement of sister and brother. If we're really serious about passing on our seat, that might just mean we need to wash some feet. If we believe in the power of Presbyterianism, I can't rhyme Presbyterianism. But if we believe in the power of connection, then wouldn't we all benefit from connecting this section of ministry staff who are on the front lines? But don't get the blessing of connecting sometimes. Go ahead and ask your Next Gen workers too, if they need this community. Spoiler alert, they do. Next Gen workers are stressed. They need relationship. You think you're oppressed, try leading a middle school trip. So the Next Gen Committee, with all of your aid, last October brought youth workers in Orlando State to be refreshed and encouraged and equipped with a task, to return to their respective presbyteries and ask, how might Next Gen workers be connected to one another and in the presbytery respected? Can we launch local networks for Next Gen workers to be mutual teachers and mutual learners? So we'll need one more go this coming fall to gather in Orlando and play dodgeball. No, I'm just kidding. We don't just eat pizza. We network and resource and also eat pizza. We're asking support from each presbytery to get workers there. We're asking support from each presbytery to get workers there with nothing to worry. And then we'll send them back with a goal and a dream to reimagine Next Gen work as a team so that networks like this can launch in each region. and make our future clearer with each passing season. See, we can pass the faith on to our students and children. We can equip and encourage those working with them. But let me step out and stop the flow to make it clear and give you the info, because I understand, I can see this might just be too long, didn't read. So last October, we brought 40 NextGen workers into Orlando. The NextGen committee hosted them for a time of encouragement and mutual edification, and also to find catalysts for regional Presbytery networks for NextGen workers. So we're hosting another one this October, thanks to the contributions of each Presbytery. And we're currently building the invite list for this, because our hope is that these NextGen workers that are invited in Orlando can then go back and strengthen the next generation ministries of each Presbytery by sharing, by networking, by launching local networks and supporting all of your NextGen workers. And then once we've had it, you can be sure to add it to your meetings packet. And we're back at it! Let me tell you straight, I won't be a dream weaver. Someone in your youth group might be the next Michael Davis. I guess it's not what you expect. The EPC's next leaders are whom our God selects, but they also might be the martyr whom God uses to reach the unreached and call whom he chooses. Next gen means our faith comes full circle. Let's circle the wagons. I promise not to bore you. And if we act up and give this more than the verbal, we'll circle up and up. There's three circles for you. We're looking for the field like a pearl in an oyster. You want to reach the nuns, don't look in a cloister. Equip and support your next gen team. They're doing the work. It's their habit and theme. Every time you pull them into the conversation, you are God's love to 1,000 generations. So my hope and prayer is that this short rhyme reminds you next gen worth is worth every dime. We can ensure our future and achieve our ideals. To God's grace and faithfulness we appeal, because this is our time, but so is 10 years from now. Will we be able to sustain this, and how? That's what next gen is trying to cultivate, the importance of which I can't overstate. Let's think about the future. That's what I exhort. And with that, Madam Moderator, this concludes our report.